isn't he?
So we're dealing with Trump the prize, six frames the aim, and Joe Johnson and Philip Studd, your commentators.
Thank you very much, Colin. Another terrific buzz about the Moser Point Arena as we get underway in semi-final two. Who's going to face Judd Trump in the title match tomorrow?
First frame.
Bingham looks Stuart relaxed. Bingham and he is, as we've already discussed, the very firm favourite to get the better of the guy who turned pro in the same year as him. They've grown up together on the snooker tour. And Bingham knows as well as anyone what Milkins is capable of when he's on a roll. But I think, Joe, a lot tonight is going to depend on how Stuart Bingham plays. If it's the Bingham of the first four frames against Stuart Carrington last night, I think it's going to be tough for Milkins to lay a glove on him. But if it's the Bingham who rather fell over the line in the second half, it could be different.
Yeah, both players wanting to win badly, and that could affect the play for sure. This is new territory, really, but Milkins hasn't been in this position many times. Would love to get into a final for the first time.
Yes, it's his first major semi-final since the International Championship in 2014. An early season injury problem with that broken collarbone, which restricted his practice for a couple of weeks. And then, as he mentioned to Neil Foulds, prevented him from using the rest properly. He has to overcome the mental hurdle of their previous meeting, of course, when he should have won. He had Bingham requiring snookers, yet somehow contrived to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory earlier this season in Manchester, the first leg of the home nations.
Wow. What a shot from Stuart Bingham. He caught it too well. Look at this again. Terrific screw back.
We saw plenty of queuing last night in the first session against Carrington like that from Bingham. He was as good as he's been all season, as he agreed after the match. And then the wheels rather fell off post the interval, but he won. That's all that matters.
Couldn't do too much with the brown.
Five.
Just made sure of the pot and given himself a chance at this red. Wait for this. He was holding his hand up a long time before the red got to the pocket. Incredible.
Missed that red by such a margin. What a fluke. Perfect position as well.
Yes, and a chance to settle now, because that would have unsettled him. Missing that red by so much. Especially if his opponent had have punished him for that mistake. Nearly missed the black, and that's why the cue ball has travelled down there for the red in the balk line. I'm pretty sure he played for the red into the left corner, with the cue ball being somewhere near the blue.
20.
Could have done with the cue ball just coming a little further down the table. 15. Himself an awkward red, either to the corner or the middle.
23.
And judged it well.
31.
Nicely played, coming round for both reds. A little harder, it would have been on the red to the right corner, but it's nicely on the red to the left corner.
39.
Well, it could take the pink this time round. Would make the next red easier. That's the angle to go into the pack of reds as well.
46.
This is the red that he fluked, missed it by a week. And he was holding his hand up as the red was coming across the table. That's what Robert Milkins thought of it. 50. But hasn't done anything wrong, Robert Milkins, so no need to beat himself up.
Yeah, I'm not quite 54. Sure how much of a consolation that'll be, though.
50. Well, he's left himself short on the pink. He wanted to be the other side of the pink to be able to disturb the reds. The wrong side of the pink. And maybe a red that goes to the right middle. 50. Well, has he spied a plant?
60.
Not safe yet. Couldn't do much the last shot. It was straight, but there is a plant there, look.
61.
And he's okay on the blue.
61. Needs this blue and another red. Milkins will need snookers.
The red to the left of the black will go. And he's nicely on that red. That was a delicate little positional shot. Could
66.
So easily have left that short. And that was frame ball.
67.
So helped by the fluke. It's a good opening frame for Stuart Bingham.
Well, when you get a big slice of luck, as Bingham did at the start of this frame, 72. You've got to try and make the most of it. No room for sympathy. Started
73.
His match with Stuart Carrington last night with a century on his way to a 4-0 interval lead. Struck the ball beautifully. There have been times when Bingham has looked out of sorts this season, but this is his sixth major semi-final of the campaign, so he's doing something right. This goes to show what a terrific match player he's become, that he's capable of winning in the lower gears.
Yeah, and a great break builder as well, Philip. Over 300 centuries to his name. Three maximums in tournament play. And absolutely loves playing.
89.
Yes, he's passionate about the sport. He has been his entire career. And remember, it took him a long time to establish himself as a leading player. He was considered a journeyman for the lion's share of his pro career before
92.
He made his breakthrough in Australia 6 years ago, and then Shanghai a couple of years later before he stunned the world with that extraordinary victory in the World Championship. And a thoroughly deserved one at that.
And it's easy to see now, isn't it, why he won that. Brilliant start. Stuart Bingham, crowd love it.
Rubbing salt into Rob Milkins' wound.
102.
Fluke was lucky. And who knows how this frame might have panned out had he not got it. As it is, Bingham quickly into his stride, just as he was against Carrington, his second century of the tournament.
109.
He can't beat the best break, which remains Mark Davis's 144 as Milkins watches on and wonders what might have been. But he'll be delighted with the start he's made here.
120.
A big chunk of luck, and he apologises again, but the rest, it must be said, was all skill from the former world champion and world number two, Stuart Bingham. A tremendous break. He clears the table and leads by a frame to nil.
Thank you. Second frame. Robert Milkins to break.
Second semi-final here at the 2017 Welsh Open. What a start from Stuart Bingham. Yes, he got a fluke early, missing a red by quite a margin and seeing a red disappear into right centre. But he then stroked in 127, cleared the table. So the firm pre-match favourite off to a flyer. This is their seventh meeting. Bingham's won five of the previous six.
Yes, and I just wonder if Robert Milkins is still suffering from that fluke, because that's not a good break-off. Could have been a frame winner. And he's had another little bit of luck there, covering the red over the right corner.
Yes, and this is an early test of Milkins' temperament. Ronnie O'Sullivan made the point that in the past there have been occasions where, when things have started to go against him, he's let his head drop And the match has very quickly slipped from his grasp. His patience has been tested here already. And what a response that is. A humdinger from Milkins. That should make him feel a bit better, even though the cue ball isn't ideal.
Yes, that's where he played the cue ball to, just in case he missed the red. He didn't leave anything, but he's left himself a tester. Yeah, that was the problem. He didn't really play for the black. He played the cue ball to the cushion, which made the next shot so much more difficult. But although he's left the red on, very difficult to get to a colour from there.
One.
Just made do with the red. Maybe send the black back down the table, play the safety.
Green.
Oh, I see. Another bit of luck.
Wowee. Well, Bingham will be hoping he hasn't used all of his luck up in the first frame and a few shots. And Milkins will be hoping that he's got plenty when it comes to the business end of the match.
Yes, I know it's a strange thing to say, Philip, but being snookered is probably better than
foul.
Being dead on the cushion.
Stuart Bingham, six.
Not going back by the looks of things. Bingham can pop this red. It was a thin one.
Not quite the snooker this time, and a chance at the red. And he's normally a very good long ball potter. Robert Milkins.
One.
Like to get the black back on its spot as soon as possible.
Robert Milkins, one.
Well, I don't think he's played on this table before, Robert. He's about to find out that these pockets are a little bit tighter than the ones around the arena where he's been playing most of his matches.
One.
Has the angle on the pink to disturb the reds. But has it worked out for him?
Seven. Stuart Bingham, seven.
Not the best safety. Speed on the cue ball, but he's sent a red towards that left corner. Difficult pot, and the cue ball could be going into the reds. Certainly didn't deserve that. Has the chance of the green or the black. But neither of those shots are easy. Both missable. And he's not used to the table yet. He doesn't like it. You can see him nodding. It's a tough pot, the black, and he could lose the frame if he misses it.
Four.
Yes, and the green was a good pot. That was missable.
Five.
He can be a very intimidating player, Robert Milkins. Strides around the table with great purpose. And it can affect his opponents.
11.
He's currently at 32 in the world, but he broke into the top 16 for the first time a few years ago. He started working with Terry Griffiths, and he got his life together off the table. He admitted that he'd had all sorts of problems, gambling and a drinking problem as well, but his domestic life settled down. He was happy at home, and he started to show that on the table. He beat Neil Robertson at the World Championship, one of his best ever wins. He's rather fallen off the radar again in the last couple of seasons, but
17.
He said that stringing together a couple of wins at the UK Championship definitely helped him to re-establish a bit of confidence. And, well, clearly he's played well this week. He's only dropped five frames to get this far. But, of course, he hasn't faced a player of the calibre of Bingham.
Yes, he played the cannon to the pink there, and it didn't work out. And probably tried to force the situation, hampered over the reds.
Robert Milkins, 17. One.
So nicely on the blue. This is the red to the middle. It was a difficult shot that played at the speed that he played it at. And put over the reds. It's ended Bingham with a great chance. I'd like to get the pink back on its spot.
Six.
Not sure if he's got the angle to play for the pink.
Seven.
Just lost the cue ball a little. Think he can still get to this red to the right corner. The red to the right of the pink has stopped the pink going into that right corner pocket. May be able to play for the pink this time round.
Not the start he had in mind. Hasn't had much rub of the green either.
26.
But if Bingham, as expected, does double his lead, this is going to be a real test of Milkins' self-belief.
Yes, Robert had a good chance there. Played the cannon to the pink. Not sure if he needed to, because there was reds that he could have played for.
33.
looks a bit fed up, doesn't he?
39.
He's got to keep believing. There's a long way to go yet. And as last night proved, you just never know. At one stage, it looked like Bingham was going to win 5-0 in no time, and it ended up being a real struggle for him.
40.
A match that could easily have gone the distance with Stuart Carrington in the end. So things can change, but Bingham monopolising the table in the early stages, looking very strong when he's in amongst them. Frame safe.
46.
I think 47. Robert Milkins' game suits Stuart Bingham because he knows he's going to get chances. And he scores very heavy, Stuart Bingham. So he'll just concentrate on his game knowing he's going to get some chances. And Robert Milkin doesn't quite score as heavy 53. As Stuart.
Yeah, Bingham, 31 centuries this season. Milkin's just four so far.
55.
Plenty for him to ponder.
Sixty-seven.
A break of 67 to go with the 1-2-7 clearance in the opening frame. Rob Milkins has barely had a look in so far. He had a chance in that one, couldn't make it pay. And Bingham extends his lead to 2-0.
Thank you. Frame three. Stuart Bingham to break.
Well, so far the bookmakers have been proved right. Stuart Bingham 3-1 on to win this match and 2-0 up already with breaks of 127 and 67. Rob Milkins has scored just 19 points on aggregate. So much for the Milkman to do if he's to deliver a shock result this evening and make his first ever ranking final. This is sixth semi-final. Never been to a final.
'Applause from the crowd, trying to G him on a bit, give him some encouragement. He's got a couple of reds that he could pop, Stuart, but they're both dangerous.
Switch it off, please.
Any time this evening would be nice.
Thank you. Settle down, please.
Ray Camilleri officiating this evening.
Yes, the double kiss. Cue ball would have been safe in the jaws of the pocket without it.
One.
He's very much a confidence player, Robert Milkins. Great to watch when they're going in. Slamming this red into the middle.
Yes, he said earlier in the season that this game is played 90% in the head, and I think that's more true of Milkins than most. He starts to believe in himself. He can be dangerous.
Well, this time the cannon to the pink has worked
Six.
Out. Has a red to that left corner, which leads him to the black. Just looking to see where he wants to be after potting the red. to have a good angle on the black to get to the next red. So I'm thinking at least two shots in front there. Not happy with being straight, but still got reds he can play for.
22, 23.
Could have done with being straighter on this red. He's going to have to play for the blue again now.
29.
But as long as he gets the right side, which he has done, it's OK. Yes, after he takes this red, he was just looking to see if it frees the red to the right corner.
35.
And it did. And maybe a chance to bring more reds into play. Send the cue ball up towards the blue.
40.
Well, again, decisions to make here. He's going to need to go into that cluster at some point. Unless there's a plant on. Could play for any one of the three reds.
48.
Oh, that's a good recovery shot. Needs that cue ball to pull up though, stay the right side of the blue, which it has done. I may decide to go into them again here. That's okay. I think he's on the red to the right corner, holds his hand up.
54.
Because that's not what he played, but if you go into them, you deserve to be on something.
55.
Well, it's getting nearer the winning line. But again, I think he needs to play a little cannon here. 55.
Missed the cannon too, just as well now. Very good break from Milkins, but there's still enough there for Bingham to hit back.
Yes, that's his first little bit of luck, because he could have hit the reds. Bingham would have had a frame-winning chance.
75 still remaining. This is a very big frame for Milkins, not just because he's anxious to get on the scoreboard as quickly as possible, but to lose a frame like this from 55 in front after what's gone before already this evening, that might be very tough to recover from.
Yeah, certainly hurt that he missed the black off the spot. So I'm with you, he needs to win this frame, otherwise could just be a step too far. Delighted to see another red go on the cushion. Yeah, what a great pot. Another great long ball potter. One. Stuart Bingham. Pink will go to that left corner. Could have played for the pink, but decided to play for the blue to give himself a chance to play the cannon to those two reds. But he's come too far. May have to take the brown here. Come round the cushions, try and play the cannon to the reds. He'd be on the red, on the black cushion if he missed those reds. Awkward cue in on the brown. And played that one well. That was a difficult shot to hold. That red to the left 16. Corner, but this is still a tough red. They play for the pink to the middle.
I've seen these missed many a time this week. But maybe they're a little bit easier now that the table has been recovered than they were earlier in the tournament, those sorts of shots.
Well, no way to get the cannon from there. Hasn't got the angle on the blue or the pink. Still 38 behind, so he could do with some points. He's thinking of bringing the black off the cushion because he's going to need that at some stage. Doesn't really matter too much about it not going in.
Stuart Bingham, 70.
The black is potable now. So Robert's got to be very, very careful when he brings this red off the cushion. Everything's going to be there. This red will pass the black. He's on dangerous ground now, Robert Milkins. This red goes in. You'd put Stuart Bingham favourite. Great pot. Great pot. And nicely round onto the blue, just to drop the blue in. He'll finish on the red. The black's over the hole. So what a decision it was to bring that black off the cushion. Stuart Bingham. Well, clever shot.
Yeah, these are very anxious moments now, aren't they, for the Milkman. 55 in front, made a good break. It wasn't quite a frame-clinching one.
Didn't have to do too much with the cue ball. Black's just sitting there. Just going to try and avoid the cannon to the pink. And the in off in the middle. Oh, that's unfortunate. Didn't want the cannon to the pink. Can he see enough of the yellow to pot it?
He can, but there's plenty of pressure on it.
Yeah, another good shot. And come round nicely for the green. I think it's the only problem ball now. He's got to finish absolutely perfect on the pink to be able to get to the black. So a very important shot this to finish right on the blue.
23.
Nothing for being straight. And that is just about right. Anxious moments for Robert Milkins.
This would be an absolute hammer blow, wouldn't it? To his hopes of making this a real contest. 55 in front.
28.
Looking good to make it 2-1.
This isn't a gimme. This is a tough shot. Looks easy on television. But still a tough shot, this. Look at the angle there.
34.
Well, he's got it.
Clean as a whistle. And this is really going to hurt Rob Milkins if this black disappears. Well, that's why Stuart Bingham is a world champion. He played a really smart frame there from 55-0 behind, choosing to get the black open. He's cleared up to pinch it to extend his lead to 3-0.
Thank you, frame four.
Welcome back to Cardiff. Rob Milkins already in deep trouble here. 3-0 down in just 42 minutes. To the former world champion Stuart Bingham, who started with a century, albeit launched by a fluke and a pretty outrageous one, then added 67. But the real killer blow potentially for Milkins, the third, when he led by 55. It was a break of 55. He broke down, and Bingham, cool as you like, managed to get back in and clear up to pinch it on the black. So 3-0. Of course, we've got an interval after this frame. And remember, hashtag Home Nations for your questions, your comments. Ronnie O'Sullivan, Neil Folds, alongside Colin Murray at half-time, so to speak. Any questions about the tournament, about this match, about prospects for tomorrow's final over the best of 17 frames? Any shots you'd like to see the Rocket recreate on our special Eurosport table? Any thoughts about how you might improve your own game? Hashtag Home Nations is the place to let us know what you're thinking. Rob Milkins, well, it's a question of whether mentally he can still keep believing he can turn this around.
Yes, I think he will think that he can still win, especially if he can win this frame. Because he'll have been behind many times, 3-0. Gone to the interval 3-1 and then started to play as he can play. So a big frame this. Well, I think he may be tempted at this red to the right corner. But it's a big shot. May be able to stand behind those two reds for the black. And there it is. He's got the angle to play that shot, but it's such a tough shot, and if he misses it, he knows he could be 4-0 down.
Not often that Milkins takes his time with his shot selection. He knows the significance of this shot. Well, he went for it, but he missed it by quite a way, and looks as though he may have got lucky.
Well, it was a clever way of playing for it. Trying not to leave anything if he missed it, which he hasn't done. He was on the black, had it gone in.
...96% outstanding. That wins a lot more matches than it loses. Bingham will be minded, though, of how things turned around pretty dramatically after the mid-session interval last night against Stuart Carrington. He went from playing the best snooker of the season for him to some of the worst, so he won't be taking anything for granted yet.
And that can be the hardest thing sometimes, like staying in control of your own nerves. Every snooker player has been through what Stuart went through yesterday. You can't miss in one session, and the next one, you can't put a ball. He was in trouble there, Robert Milkins. Decided to stun the red down the table. And it was a containing safety shot. That's worked. But now that that red's gone down the table, they have to try and play the safety down this end of the table. He's looking at playing the cue ball into the balk area, into the jaws of the yellow pocket, using the green to hide that red in balk. But it's a dangerous shot, this. If it gets the speed wrong, leaves the red on. And that's a good safety. Not quite a snooker. Now, is he going to get some luck? Wasn't easy that. So he's got a chance again. Made 55 in the last frame.
It thought about staying out, but it dropped.
Six. Seven.
That wasn't straightforward. He couldn't just go into the reds. Had to play that delicate cannon, trying to leave himself on the red to the middle. And that is a good recovery shot. That was well and truly missable. In fact, he missed one similar to that in the second frame.
Well, at least that 55 break in the previous frame, albeit ultimately in vain, allowed him the opportunity to get a feel for the table. It should stand him in good stead for this contribution.
21.
Not happy with that one, though. The wrong side of the blue. He's played that.
26.
Looks like he can play for the black here. And shouldn't leave anything if it doesn't go in.
Robert Milkins, 26.
Just what he needed, a let off. No chance of getting that cue ball in behind the green here. Chose to play the pot, which would have been a better shot had it gone in. Well, when it was coming down the table, I thought it was in. So close, that.
I think Stuart thought it was in as well. Couldn't have been any closer.
Well, that was a very, very good shot. There's no room for error there. And he's the right side of the blue. Might be able to disturb something. Plenty of topspin on the cue ball. Hasn't been fortunate.
Six.
Very risky to play that possible plant. Could have done with missing those two reds and hitting the reds below them. Would have had the reds to the middle then.
Robert Milkins, six.
doesn't get any better than that. One. He was forced into taking this red on. And deserved to be nicer on the black.
We've seen that a few times this evening, though, haven't we? A terrific pot followed by a mistake.
It was such a difficult pot, the black. Full marks for taking it on.
Perhaps worthy of a little bit more care, but that's the way Milkins plays. He's an instinctive player, isn't he? He gets down, he sights it, and he shoots.
One.
When he's really on it, it can pay off handsomely, but there are times when it can be very costly, as it may well be here. 32 points behind Bingham, but that lead of Milkins may evaporate pretty quickly.
Trusted to luck a little bit. Hoping to be on something easy. He's on a red to the middle, to the corner.
Nine.
And that spells danger for Robert Milkins. Good recovery shot. Perfectly onto the black, and nothing safe.
Sixty.
Well, he's underhit that one slightly. Have to go up for the blue now.
Milkins sits in his chair wondering if it's going to be 4-0 at the interval, 22. Which would be nigh on impossible to turn around, you would think. Stuart Bingham chasing his first title since he lifted the world crown at the Crucible, which of course celebrates its 40th anniversary this spring, 1977. John Spencer defeated Cliff Thorburn in the first ever Crucible final. Mark Selby will be going for a hat-trick of titles as defending champion in the middle of April. It's coming around quickly, Joe.
So quick, isn't it?
29.
Can't believe how quickly it's come round. Milkins, not thinking about that as yet. There's a lot to think about out there.
30.
Yeah, the third frame felt like such a big one, didn't it? 55 in front, going well. But Bingham got back in that ice cool clearance of 41 to break Milkins' heart on the black.
36.
Threatening to inflict more damage.
Well, a little kick. Didn't affect
37.
The red going in the pocket. I think the key shot in that last frame is when Bingham brought the black off the cushion. That enabled him to clear the table. Knocked in a really good long red.
Yep.
It's been pretty brisk, which is what we expected. Two players who like to attack. Not much in the way of safety.
Forty-four. 51.
Well, just lost the cue ball a little there. Might make a difference on the next shot. May have to play the cannon to the red to hold for the red. Or the pink. They could just about hold for the red.
59.
Turning into an evening to forget at the moment for Rob Milkins. He had high hopes, having made his first semi-final since 2014.
60.
Excellent win over Kurt Mafflin in the previous round.
60.
But at the moment, Bingham is outplaying him in all departments. His pot success remains in the mid-90s, a full 10 percentage 66. Points better than Milkins. And he's knocking in the breaks.
68.
127 in the first frame, albeit helped by that early fluke. 67 and then the 41 clearance, just as important. Arguably more so, actually. That was a frame that had Milkins won it, as looked likely at one stage. Well, it could have changed the whole dynamic of the evening, but now, just as he was last night, Bingham in complete control. Milkins is going to have to hope that Bingham's form drops alarmingly after the mid-session break.
71 in frame, Stuart Bingham.
But somehow, you have to doubt it. Bingham means business this evening. He wants more silverware. He wants another showdown with Judd Trump in the final. And he's well on his way to achieving that goal. After four frames, Bingham firmly in charge. It's a whitewash session, 4-0. Yes, a mountain to climb for Milkins. And I think he just has to go for it now. That's generally his style in any case, but I think the only way he can get back into this is start scoring heavily, get himself in and attack the balls and do what he does best. But Stuart Bingham, I'm sure, will
be
mindful of what happened last night
Stuart
and determined that it doesn't happen again. He wants a quick kill. He wants to be ruthless and save himself for a showdown with the Juddernaut tomorrow. Two frames away from another major final.
'll be interesting to see how Rob Milkins plays from here on in. Whether he can find something. Obviously, he's pleased to have got this far, but he won't be happy with that at this point. But the fact is, two or three of the frames, certainly two, he probably could or should have won. More like it. He'll get a bit more support. He's already got a bit in here, but he'll get a bit more now that he is behind. People will be looking for a closer match.
There's been nothing wrong with his long game this evening. Five out of six now. And what a shot that is. Well, that's ultra positive. And he couldn't have played that any better.
Five.
Yes, very fine shot. The shot is on, but you've got to execute the shot properly. That's okay.
Six.
You had to use a little bit left-hand side, or else I think he'd have been in behind that red for the black, but as we've seen, these are tough. He's going to have to drop this in, I think, giving the pocket the most chance. I'm afraid that is not close. It's not an easy shot.
Robert Milken, six.
It really isn't. It's almost more difficult being just off straight. More straight, he wanted a bit more angle, he might have approached it, but alongside me, Philip shook his head straight away. He knew it was never in, was it?
Yeah. Just mishit it, but it's difficult, isn't it, when you're 4-0 down. Nothing's gone his way this evening.
No, and that wasn't a good look, was it, we saw from him in his chair. He looks pretty despondent, I think. For Stuart Bingham, he has to continue. You know, you cannot let anybody back into a match. Got to continue to plough on. Got to get to six as quickly as he can.
I'm sure he'll have been a little bit frustrated with the way he allowed Stuart Carrington back in last night. It could have ended in tears. Carrington was very close to forcing
six.
A decider. That could have been very edgy for Bingham. So he'll be keen to make amends this evening and put this away with a minimum of fuss.
Yeah, and Carrington, a different sort of player. Someone that did manage to, once he won a frame, really dug in. What a gritty player he is. Milkins is higher ranked.
Seven.
And he's more of a flair player. But he's finding it very difficult to get any kind of a blow in this match tonight. And he's really presented a wonderful chance. Don't forget these reds were scattered by him from the shot on the brown. And Stuart is likely to be the beneficiary of all of that here.
Not the first time that's happened this evening. Milkins has potted a couple of superb balls to get in, and then very soon afterwards has missed and presented Bingham with a scoring opportunity. And he's by and large punished him to the full. 127, 67, 41, that excellent clearance in the third, which I think
50.
Felt even at that early stage of the match like a potentially fatal blow for Milkins after he led by 55. And then the 71 for 4-0. It's been a very clinical display so far from world number two.
20.
Well, that is not a good shot. That really is not good. Of all the places to finish on the table, and there are many where he's on something, that is not one of them. The red he's left with is a thin cutback to the right corner. That's a terrible shot, in fact. A long time on this shot. Well, that's annoying in every way.
Stuart Bingham.
If there's ever going to be any sort of a turning point in this match, I think that might have been it. I'm not saying it's about to change, but Stuart really, that was as bad a positional shot he's played all season to finish where he did. There's so many reds available. Tight down there, isn't it, along that cushion? Rob puts his hand up to apologise, but I wouldn't be too apologetic. Not really. not the way the match has gone.
4-0 down in a race to six. The evening got off to the worst possible start for Milkins when Bingham profited from that huge fluke, promptly cleared the table. And it's never got any better for him since then.
A bit short of pace on that one. Now, Milkins with a chance here. He could really use that going in.
They have to go in now. Not much room to manoeuvre at 4-0 down. But equally, I think he has to attack because that's all he really knows. The £20,000 cheque will certainly be welcome for Milkins, assuming it is defeat this evening. That's more than 50% of what he's earned in the whole of this season to date, as he looks to get back up the rankings, currently at 32, but he has been in the 16. Although he's now 40, well, recent history tells us that's no bar to success, so he's got time to get back up amongst the game's elite, and he'll take plenty out of his first semi-final for a couple of years.
And that was a really good positional shot there from the blue. He really got that cue ball to bite with a little bit of left-hand side and screw, and he played it ever so well. In contrast to the previous shot, where the last break broke down. Seven. Anyway, he's in again. We're seeing more of the same here. It's been a very dominant and one-sided match. And what he has done, Stuart, not so much in this match, but over the last month or two, I've been watching him. He's been struggling, really struggling, 40. Just striving to find something in his game, that little bit of extra zest that you get, timing when you're playing well. He's 50. Not had it, but he's been looking for it and practicing hard, yep. And gradually he's getting somewhere near the form that won in the world title, but it's not as good.
You've seen that rather resigned expression a few times this evening from Rob. In fact, he's worn it practically since he shook hands with Bingham at the start of the match. Yeah, it says something about Bingham's strength when he's not playing at his best, that
21.
You know, this is his sixth semi-final of the season. He's already trousered over £250,000. And there's plenty still to come before the campaign's over, so taken a leaf out of Mark Selby's book at times during this season. Not playing at his best, but grinding out results.
22.
And signs now that perhaps he is beginning to find his best form with the World Championship homing into view.
Well, he's got a bit of work to do here, but three reds in open play put that man even further behind.
Has been a pretty one-sided matchup down the years between this pair. Milkins with just one win out of six, but there's never been a whitewash victory for Stuart Bingham. Most of them have been reasonably close. Not least, of course, their most recent meeting, which Milkins really should have won from the snooker's required stage. And a slightly rueful smile out of camera shot there from Rob Milkins as Stuart Bingham manoeuvres himself into a position where he can clinch this frame.
Well, he's got a bit to do here. Well played. He hit quite firmly for what was quite an acute angle. And that is the frame now. I don't see any way back. Now this has gone in at speed. This is another frame gone. And 5-0 up in the best of 11 is not a scoreline that is turned around very often. I can only think of a 45. Couple ever.
Yeah, it happened to Barry Hawkins, didn't it? Against Nigel Bond at the UK a couple of seasons back.
46.
Took Hawkins a few months to get over that. I don't think Bingham is in the mood to let this slip.
Fifty-four.
It's been very solid scoring from Stuart Bingham this evening. Four breaks of over 50, including the century clearance in the opener. And just as important, the 41 clearance in the third, which 61. May well have broken Rob Milkins' spirit. Ramey looked like winning. Well, that red is academic. The frame is long since won, and Rob Milkins looking a little resigned to his fate now as Stuart Bingham starts strongly after the interval. Unlike last night against Carrington, he's now a frame away at 5-0.
Thank you. Frame six. Robert Milkins to back.
Realistically, Rob Milkins' hopes of a first ever ranking final have gone. He's 5-0 down to the world number two and former world champion Stuart Bingham. So I guess pride is the primary goal for the time being, at least. Try and get at least a frame on the board. Avoid the dreaded whitewash. But you have to give a lot of credit to Bingham. He's been rock solid this evening in all departments. Perhaps not quite as scintillating as he was in the first four frames last night against Stuart Carrington, but he's queuing well again. There's no doubt about that.
Well, his pot success is 94%. Sadly, Rob Milkins down to 80. So I think it underlines the fact that he has played well enough. And again, we'll see or hear maybe some support for the Gloucester man for however long that remains in this match, given that he's the underdog and people would like to see him win a frame at least.
The first of those six semi-finals was back in 2005, the Irish Masters He's never come closer to making a final than he did in that match against Matthew Stevens. He led by three with four to play. Only to be pipped at the post. And I think he probably assumed then that there'd be plenty more opportunities. Still waiting for that elusive final in a ranking event. But this is easily his best performance of the season so far. Made one quarter-final, but there's been precious little else in the last season and a half to write home about, so it's definitely progress for Milkins, whatever happens for the rest of this match.
Played it well, right in behind the brown, and the further in the middle of the table along the bolt cushion you can get it, the more difficult it is to get out of there. Is you can see reds, getting a thin safety out of one of these, not easy.
Yeah, Milkins has actually managed to match Stuart Bingham in the safety department this evening. Getting in hasn't been the problem for him, it's been staying in. Chris Gunter, the Reading and Wales defender, formerly of Spurs, I believe. Snooker fan.
Well, as he covered everything, it appears that nothing really easy goes there. The only thing about playing one of those containing shots, and of course sometimes you have to, is that you give your opponent the chance to really get you in more trouble. Stuart's got, he can get the cue ball in a number of difficult places now. Leaving yellow is not a good shot, really. I think he's avoided one there, avoided a problem as Rob Milkins.
Milkins' patience running dry at the moment. Which shows he still cares. He still desperately wants to compete in this match, even though it's looking like a lost cause.
Foul.
Ah, he's fouled. Did he touch one of the ball colours there? It was a good pop.
I don't think many of the audience heard that call of foul from Terry Camilleri. So they might wonder what happened there, but you heard he called a foul right at the moment when he struck the ball. Let's have a look. Yeah, well, that's the green's moved about 3 inches. He saw it. Stuart would have owned up to it anyway. another containing shot. And another chance for Stewart maybe to put him into more trouble. Think of the two reds close together. I mean, he may have the shot just skim off those, but he would maybe leave one of them out. Potable. But I think in behind brown and yellow is a possibility here. Even better, the fact that he was on that red, that's a very fine shot. And it was pretty safe as well. He's found one that went there that didn't appear to be... He's gone through the smallest of gaps to the middle bag. Very fine shot.
Six.
Well, if that one goes, and it seems that it might, that opens everything up. I'm sure there's enough of the potting angle there, and that makes a huge difference.
Seven.
Looks like being a sad end to what has been a very encouraging tournament for Rob Milkins.
Well, plenty of opportunities to finish off this match.
And 28.
Be much reward for some hard work for Stewart to reach a final. Not won anything since he became world champion in 2015. Been in a few semi-finals and finals since, but a big showpiece event here in Cardiff tomorrow, and he'll be a part of it, and he's almost there.
It would be his second final of the season, but his first at ranking level. Of course, he played John Higgins in the China Championship 35. Final, a brand new invitational event, although when it's staged later this year, it'll become a full-blown ranking event. And it took something pretty spectacular from Higgins to deny him the title. They were locked at 7-all, and Higgins finished the match with 3 centuries. He has had the misfortune at times this season
36
in the big matches to run into opponents playing at the very peak of their game. Just a few signs, both last night and tonight, that he might be pretty close to his peak again. That makes him very dangerous.
43. 44.
Of course, Judd Trump was one of Bingham's victims when he lifted the world title, that memorable semi-final which went to the wire. They have played a couple of times since then. One win apiece, but if it is to be Trump Bingham, as looks likely now, it has the makings for another nail biter.
51 52.
His fifth break of 50 or more this evening.
51. Yeah, I don't see any way back now. It's looking awfully like this match is going to be over quite soon. He has to just complete the job. As you say, 54 the difference. Still 75 on. But of course, the remaining goes down by 8 every time a red is potted.
59.
So I think his own score is going to go past that shortly. 51. I think we're almost at that point now. So here we are. Match ball.
65.
That man's had a bad night at the office, but a good week in general.
66.
Yes, Stuart Bingham has outscored Milkins by more than 4-1 this evening. He's dominated the table. Possibility of a century to finish as he started. As things stand, £2,700 winging its way to the Jessie May charity. Our sponsors, Coral, giving £50 for every century break made to that wonderful cause, the Children's Hospice. And the pressure now off Bingham. He can concentrate on trying to finish with a flourish. Barely an hour and a half old. The century is a distinct possibility now. Well, it's been an arresting performance. 81. Played some wonderful stuff early on against Stuart Carrington last night. Didn't entirely convince
87.
Either way. He finished the match, but tonight he has been the definition of clinical.
88.
And we're set for a mouth-watering finale to this most compelling of Welsh Open tournaments. We've had upsets galore, we've had some great stories, new players emerging. But we're left with 95. A couple of the relatively older guard.
96.
Proven winners. Going head-to-head over 17 frames tomorrow, Judd Trump and Stuart Bingham. There's the century. He started with a 127.
101.
And he's finishing in similar fashion. And I'm sure he'll be delighted at the way in which he's been able to punish his opponents every mistake.
101,
that was clinical from Stuart Bingham. What a performance from the former world champion over poor old Rob Milkins, who didn't win a frame tonight. Not his night. He's had a good tournament, but Stuart Bingham was deadly. And what a final we have on our hands now. Bingham against Trump. What a performance from the former world champion. The world number two brushes aside Rob Milkins by 6 frames to 0.